Your fucking hands up.
Hello, my dear friends. I am Virágos, and in this video, I would like to show you, or I would like to represent you some simple but very useful pieces of advice on how to become a strong player in Gomoku. And if you are new to this channel, please give us a thumb up below the video, like the video and subscribe to our channel. So I currently have the Grandmaster title with my major username Virágos at the Fly or Die Gomoku server, which is the highest rank in the game. I am okay, so we are with X. We are with X, and let's try something interesting. Let's try this. So in this video, I am going to talk about now which factors are important to you in order to become a strong Gomoku player, or which factors are crucial in increasing your playing strengths in Gomoku, how to develop more efficiently. My first piece of advice is have a strong opening with X. As you know, Gomoku is an open game, and this means you can take your pieces wherever you want. So Gomoku is a much more free game compared to chess. And let's see, here is my main move is here. Okay. So Gomoku is an open game, and this means you can take your pieces wherever you want. So Gomoku is a much more free game compared to chess. I'm also a tournament chess player. I have been playing chess more than 20 years, so I have a lot of experience in chess. Okay, so here we are, and the main factor which determines how strong player you are in Gomoku is your opening, especially when you are playing with X. And the main thing here is the stronger and more complex your opening is, the more stronger player you are. Okay, so here we are. I think that X has almost winning combination somehow. Yes, here. X has some winning combination here. I don't know if you see that. Okay, let's try this. Okay. Yes. Okay, and here this can be a victory if yes, maybe this can be a very strong move because I'm settling to g10 or f12. Yes, this is f12 and this is the win, f12. So okay, so I clearly spent some time because I am preparing for okay, so here we are, we are with circle now. And my second piece is advice is always calculate during the game, and it is very important to calculate accurately. So it is very important not to play random moves. Don't play random moves. you should always have a plan to attack and how to win during the game. Calculate accurately and precisely, and don't make a calculation mistake. And this is some kind of standard SV, so this in this H7 move would be standard SV, standard SW threat. And here is the threat, I think, at, yes, here. Maybe, maybe here. Okay, so maybe a E7 could be her, could be his next move. Okay, he is a good player. He is almost a master. The master title is about 350 points, and the grandmaster title is from 480 points. The grandmaster title is the red colored title. Okay, so now he is better here, unfortunately. And yes. And what could be his plan? Maybe here. So I have to defend here. But how? Maybe here. Okay, I have to attack now. I have to attack somehow because he threatens some. This is a quite difficult position for me. Okay. So this is a must because I am trying to avoid any ideas after G9 and G9 and maybe H8 because so this move was about that I am trying to avoid that he has any ideas on this E row. Okay, and so this I think it is needed to defend this up. Okay, so his next move may be G11 and K7, then maybe H8 or J7 would be a strong move, but X is better here. X is better here. Oh my god. And X not only better, but X is winning. Because H12 and H11. Yes, yes. That is not too good. That is not too good. Yeah. I wonder if he would give me a rematch or not. But he's quite. I expect he will run. Okay, this was I clearly made a mistake. Okay, clearly made a calculation mistake, but he's playing very slow. He's playing a slow and a strange game. Okay, and he didn't accept my okay, so this is the third game, and here we are. I am playing with almost master level player. Okay, okay, here we are. So we are with X, and okay. Oh, okay. And this is very important. So this is exactly what I said, you guys. The opening is very crucial. So K6. Then so X has almost. Winning advantage here, and X has a winning advantage here. X has is much better because circle cannot defend properly. Maybe G, yeah. Okay. Yeah, and this is a win because he has to defend on h3. Then I made here. No, hit. Okay, and this is l5 is the threat. Then k. Then I win with k4 with double three. With double three. So this is the most important factor, which clearly determines how strong player you are, is how is your opening in Gomoku. And this is especially here because Gomoku is an open game. Okay, let's see the rematch. Okay, now we circle, and with circle it is very important to play. So this is not a good not a good idea. This is a kind of HW. Not HW, but a kind of P7 opening, and this is not a good idea. When and this H8 move would be much better because X cannot connect his pieces, and this is not too good. Okay, because of the nature of the game, I have to defend here. A little bit defend, and he is next. Yes, I expect that. Maybe c8, I think. Yeah. So when you are playing with circle, it is very important to decide. And this is the threat. c8. This is the threat. c8 is the threat. So when you are playing with circle, it is very important to. To determine when it is needed to attack and when it is needed to defend somehow. Here. Yes. So this is a three. I have to block this. Okay. Okay. So this is a very dangerous position for me, and I cannot because this is not a win. This is not a win, but yeah, here is the win. Here is the win. Oh. Okay, somehow I should win this, but I don't know how. Okay, let's try. Somehow I have a much better position here. Let's see here. Here. Okay, so. Play here. Let's play here. Now, okay. I really hope that I don't, but I that I don't lose because he has this e4 move, and this can be very dangerous for me. So my the threat here is g9, then e9, and this is the winning for me. And if he defends, I still have got this. This either d11, f11, and e11 move. So this is a winning for me. This is a winning for me with 5. Here. So this is a winning for me on the 11th row. Here. And this is e11 is a winning for circle. Okay. So and he probably try e4, then h. H4, but after I defend this, I am winning. Okay, so this is a winning for circle. So it is very important to choose your opening in Gomoku very carefully. Yes, and the preparation for this video take me some time, and that's why I told you here and here. I told you, well, this is a timing move. Circle is winning here. So you should always have a plan to attack and how to win during the game. Calculate accurately and precisely, and don't make a calculation mistake. So this is here a win for me. Okay, thank you, Mr. Lotzi. Maybe another game? Yeah, another game. Okay, so choose your opening very carefully and choose a very strong opening. Okay, maybe, but after h7, he would be this f6 move, so that's why I go for g5. G5 and this is almost already a winning for me. This is a kind of SW shape. After this move, I theoretically winning again. And after this move, I win again. So this is a 3-0 for me because it is a very, very strong opening and he don't defend accurately. Okay, here. Okay, block. And this is winning for X, clearly. My main move will be, so he had to defend here, and then this h7 would be the appropriate defense, because I have this, then I have this g6, g8, and h7 very strong attack. But X is winning here. X has a winning, yes. See? I said exactly this. Okay. Let's try something interesting. This could be a win for me somehow. Okay, let's try this. Let's try this. He will defend on ES and E. Let's try this. And let's try. Okay, let's try this. Something interesting. So with this F7 move would be much weaker for me because after F7, he would immediately block on J4. Yes, but this is, so another important thing in Gomoku, who is the faster player? And now I have this if I move, and I am winning here with 5. See, he have to block, then L3, and then I have the win here. So it is very important to always calculate. Okay, thank you. Very, very good.